It's the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Monday, the 31st of August. I'm Michael Groff. Today is the last day of meteorological summer, and it does feel just a little bit cooler out there this morning, thanks to all the active weather we had over the weekend. And we will still have chances of rain around today and tomorrow, but moisture levels trend down, and temperatures will be trending up as we head through the rest of the week and into the weekend. Let's talk about it. Yesterday, 103 degrees, the afternoon high. 77 was the low. That occurred at 10:48 p.m. And no rain in the bucket, neither yesterday or on Saturday, officially at Sky Harbor. But some spots saw a deluge, as I'll show you in just a moment. Outside now, here at 6:55 a.m., we've got partly cloudy skies out there this morning. And we're starting out at 79 degrees in Sky Harbor, dew points at 64, relative humidity 61%. The winds are calm and the barometer is rising. And how about this for temperatures out there this morning? Everybody is in the 70s. When's the last time we had a map that looked like this? 71, the cool spot at Thompson Peak and Goldfield. And that's thanks to all the rain we had around this weekend. Speaking of, here we go. This is the weekend rainfall totals. And you can see that the big winner on this map, way over on the far right-hand side of the screen there, Apache Junction, 1.79 inches, 9,900ths of an inch, way out west on Camelback and Turner Road. And amounts varied quite a bit, but you'll notice the big hole in the middle. Yes, nothing for Phoenix, Tempe, Scottsdale, and some of those areas there. And that's just the way the monsoon works sometimes. Even though this isn't really a monsoon pattern, check it out, the upper air look. High pressure is suppressed to the south and east, and the flow aloft is westerly. And the only reason we had any moisture around is thanks to those tropical systems that we talked about last week off the Baja, sending quite a bit of moisture up into the southwestern United States. Now, over time, this moisture will get pushed off to the east. You can see it on the infrared satellite view, the very clear westerly flow, and most of the clouds now off across far eastern Arizona and over New Mexico. But we will have another round of showers and storms fire up today and possibly again tomorrow, as we'll outline in just a moment. The watch warning map, we've got heat advisories over a good portion of Texas and Louisiana, a severe thunderstorm watch, extreme eastern Oklahoma and Arkansas. Out here in the west, red flag warnings aplenty and high fire danger continues to be the story. Couple of frost advisories up across portions of the Rockies as well. Convective outlook for today, the slight risk of severe storms to include Tulsa and Little Rock, as well as Kansas City and Memphis. And precipitation valid through next Monday morning from the WPC. Rain amounts in Phoenix generally at or under 1/4 of an inch. Heavier totals in some of the favored higher terrain areas. Your amount will vary, as you have seen. And let's take a look at modeling right now, see what's going on with this weather pattern. Here we go. The GFS, the O6Z run valid at 2 o'clock this afternoon. A big ridge of high pressure out there over the east and northeast Pacific, and that's going to be nosing in here with time. We've got troughing and a short wave developing to the north of the state. A mainly westerly flow around here today. Not a typical monsoon flow for sure. So down at the surface, partly cloudy skies, widely scattered showers and thunderstorms will develop over the higher terrain. And perhaps across the south central deserts, although I think with all the rain we had yesterday, the atmosphere is sufficiently worked over. Still, an isolated storm is not out of the question across the area, so we'll put a 10% chance in for this afternoon. High temperatures, upper 90s to near 100. Tonight, the skies are partly cloudy, widely scattered showers and storms develop, but a short wave will drop in from the north across the Four Corners region, and that might ignite more scattered, maybe even numerous showers and storms over far eastern Arizona. And so we'll have to watch that very carefully. And overnight lows should be in the mid-70s to low 80s. And then tomorrow, we'll do it again. The westerly flow continues, but widely scattered showers and thunderstorms are possible. And some of the guidance suggests storms could be a little bit more numerous tomorrow. It's kind of a complicated setup, but I do think that despite the fact that that trough access will move to the east, there's still enough moisture and cool air aloft to facilitate at least widely scattered thunderstorms even here in the south central deserts, but they will be moving west to east, not the most favorable flow to get widespread storms into the valley, but that is still a possibility. High temperatures tomorrow again, mid-90s to around 100. As we go to Wednesday and beyond, we'll be entering into a very persistent weather pattern with high pressure building in from the Pacific Northwest into the Great Basin. The flow aloft turns out of the northwest or even northerly, so we dry out and warm up quickly. Upper 90s to near 100 on Wednesday, 101 to 104 on Thursday, 105 to 108 for the highs on Friday. And then over the weekend, the Labor Day weekend looks dry and hot with highs 107 to 110 for both Saturday and Sunday. The GFS shows some isolated showers and thunderstorms over the higher terrain, but I kind of doubt that will happen as the moisture is really scoured out of here. And then here's a week from today. This is Monday, Labor Day, the 7th, and a very high amplitude pattern. Trough across the east, very cool temperatures there, and a big heat ridge out here in the west. So we're still looking hot and dry with temperatures pretty close to 110. We've already had 50 days with a high temperature of 110 plus, so we likely will be tacking on to that at some point. And then going out 10 days to the end of the period, this is Wednesday the 9th. Look at that bowling ball low that the GFS is putting down toward the Tennessee Valley. I think that's probably overdone. But all the global models pretty much agree on a sprawling ridge continuing out here in the west, and the GFS shows that as well. 594 heat ridge over the Great Basin, so we're still hot and dry. All right, let's look at precipitation off the SREF, the short-range ensemble forecast, because I don't think we'll have any precipitation chances after Wednesday. And it's got the ensemble mean under a tenth of an inch, and some of the members show nothing. So there is still a chance we could see some rain today or tomorrow here in the valley. I think tomorrow might actually be the better chance. And then temperatures off the national blend of models, pretty close to the century mark through Wednesday, and then a dramatic warm-up as we see highs getting pretty close to 110 for the weekend and beyond as this summer just drags on. And that's going to do it for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video back here tomorrow morning. If you enjoy these videos, be sure to subscribe, like, share, and click the notification bell so that whenever a brand new video is posted, you'll get the notice. Your comments, questions, and suggestions always encouraged as well. I thank you so very much for watching. You guys be safe, stay cool out there, drink plenty of water, watch your kids around the swimming pool, and have yourselves a great Monday.